Today in the pedal world, the Lichtlärm Audio Amber Spyglass.
The Amber Spyglass is an EQ pedal combined with a boost, and it's built by Lichtlärm Audio, a small one-man company localized in Berlin. The name Amber Spyglass is based on Philip Pullman's His Dark Materials trilogy, and if you haven't read it, you definitely should. It's a very great read. So, the Amber Spyglass comes in this nice black metal housing with its nice white artwork. It has volume control and a four band EQ, your bass, low mids, high mid and treble. So let's go right into span and check out what those knobs actually do. By the way, there are no internal trim pots. Okay, so activate. Very subtle change. Now volume, of course, goes all the way down. Don't need to show it, and you can crank it quite nicely. Also seems to be very linear. So now the bass control. Around the 70 to 80 hertz region here. And you can even cut it. So we are here around minus 68. And minus 53. So we got around 15 dB. The low mid control has its center frequency around the 400 hertz region. Also some nice cutting option, the high mid, centered around 1.2 kilohertz. And treble is roughly centered around 4.5 kilohertz. With some nice cutting options. So now let's see if they interact with each other. We reduce the bass, crank the low. Let's do something strange. Okay, now what happens when we reduce the low mid? Nothing here. And nothing here. I think it's good. Okay, let's go to the playthrough. Thank you.
Okay, I want to spoil it for you right here. This is one of the best sounding pedals I had here recently. It's basically just a 4-band EQ with a boost, but the 4 bands are chosen very musically and very tasteful. You can improve your sound drastically. I liked the possibilities it gave you both in front of a clean amp as well as of the distorted amp. And you can use it in the FX loop to shape your sound even more drastic if you like it this way. Me personally, I use it now mainly in front of the distorted amp as a kind of lead sound. So, for example, my rhythm sound is HM2 based and my lead sound would be Amp Spyglass, maybe, or a combination. I can just add it to the sound. So it's very usable. I really like the high mid, especially. It gives you some nice, almost chainsawish flavor, but not really. And you can dial back the bass, the low mid, or you can add it, especially for some thick, clean sounds. So very, very good. I have one thing to mention though, because I think it's important. When you put it in front of a clean amp or in the FX loop with a clean amp and you crank the treble, there is some noise, but that's natural. It comes when boosting those very high frequencies. So you have to be aware when you search for something to give you more high end, maybe you also increase the noise. Anyways, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. May the force be with you and have a nice day.